live stream, so I can hear exactly what you're saying from downstairs. So please, thank you.
Good. Thank you. welcome home. Great to have you all here. It's great to see everybody. We're also live streaming this Mass, so you may be famous and see yourself on TV later. We thank you for being here this morning, and I know how very special it is, especially on this very beautiful feast of Corpus Christi, to once again be together as a family, to offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass to Almighty God, and for many of you for the first time in over 3 months to receive Holy Communion for the first time. So it's almost like receiving First Communion all over again. So it's a great joy for us to be here. As you can see, things are a little bit different here in church, and hopefully it won't be this long, this way for a long time. But in the meantime, we ask you if you can, please wear a face mask or face covering as you're here in church. If you keep your distance apart from one another, for Holy Communion, it would be a little bit different. We ask that you come one at a time in the aisle. Father Clarke will be over by the tabernacle. I will be here in the middle of the church. The kneeler is there as a distance. If you wish to kneel down for Holy Communion, please feel free to do that as well. But if you just keep that distance. And then as you're coming up, the person in front of you, just remove the mask to receive Holy Communion, and you can put the mask back on as you go back to your chair. That would be great. I don't believe as a pastor I'm going to say this, but I'm going to say it anyway. There's no collection to be taken up. But as you do leave church, there are baskets by the door. If you want to drop off your envelope there, it's fine. If you want to mail it or drop it off the rectory, whatever's easier and convenient for you, that'll be fine as well. Also, on our website, as you can see, there's no missalettes allowed in the pews, but there are at the table. So please, take one home with you and bring it back to church whenever you come. They're yours. We just can't have them left here in church. So as the doors of the church are missalettes, please take them with you and follow along with the Mass, and then take them as you go along. Also on our website is a download of our Mass program every week. So if you want on your iPhone or iPad, bring that to church with you and follow along. You can do that as well. So in the meantime, I know it's been a long time for us to be here together, but certainly, as you know, the solemn obligation to attend Mass on Sundays has been suspended. So if you're feeling sick or under the weather or just don't feel like being with the crowd, please stay at home. We're live streaming 10:30 Mass every week. As you know, also downstairs is available, as well as the choir loft as well. So whatever it is to make yourself comfortable in the presence of God, please do so. But in the meantime, we thank God for the great gift of being able together here. And so we begin our prayer to Almighty God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace and the peace of God our Father, and the love of the Divine Son, and the community of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My dear friends, we acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves worthily to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through our most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us the memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, food unknown to your fathers, the word of the Lord." From the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord. Indeed, how truly grateful we are to Almighty God that he allows us to come together for the first time on this very important and very beautiful solemnity of Corpus Christi, the body and blood of our Lord. The very center, the very core of what it means for us to be Catholics. To come as a family, to join our humble prayers with the greatest prayer that was known to us, the prayer of Jesus himself, as he offered to the Heavenly Father the sacrifice of his life, where the blood and the body were separated, and he died upon that cross, redeeming us, saving us, and knowing, of course, human nature, and how our memories sometimes are very short. I like the word that we heard in the first reading, the very first word of Moses, remember. And our Lord gave us something for us to remember. He gave us himself. Not just a symbol. Not just an idea. Not just a concept. But himself. For all love always wants to be in union with the beloved. Christ wants to be in union with us. And he gives us himself. How? In the form of bread. The very stable of all diet, of all food. Every country, every culture has their own unique bread. Interesting. And bread really is the only food that you can eat at all three meals a day. All in its unique place. Bread. The most common of all foods. The most lowly of all foods. The most important. The thing about food is not only do we need it to live, but we need it every day. And so our Lord, to help us remember, comes to us as daily bread. And we pray for that every time we pray the Our Father. Give us this day our daily bread. Not just physical bread, but more importantly, the spiritual. Give us yourself, Lord. And he does. And how blessed we are to have the Catholic faith. To believe that what we receive is not just a piece of bread or a symbol, but the real body and blood, soul and divinity of Christ who hung upon the cross for you and for me. It is that reception of Holy Communion that become into us, but forms who we are, and we become what we eat. We become who we eat. The memorial of God's love. So how blessed we are He'll be able for some of you the first time in 93 days. Receive Christ himself again. That which you have starved for. That who you longed for. People I talked to whenever I saw them. When are we getting back to church? When are we going to be able to receive Holy Communion again? It was, in many ways, like the Jewish people in the desert. We were in exile. But just as God gave them bread from heaven, here we are today, receiving the Lord himself. It is that courage that we receive. That courage that gives us the strength to fight the good fight. Not to give up. To live that Christian life. It is the Eucharist that helps us to live that Christian lifestyle. In the midst of a world that is so taken away from us. And does everything possible for us not to live a Christian life. It riles up our anger. It frustrates us. It's the Eucharist that gives us that peace and that calm that we need in life. There are difficult days come our way, sickness or death of a loved one. What gives us the strength to get out of bed the next day? Eucharist. What gives us the strength to live a good and moral life? Eucharist. What gives us the strength to help other people in their need and forget about our own needs? Christ himself in the Eucharist. And the more we receive the Lord in our life, the more confidence we have in who we are. The more confidence we have, we are. And so today, at this beautiful feast, let us bring our issues, the difficulties of our life, and lay them on this altar. And just as a piece of bread and a cup of wine will become the very body and blood of Christ, so will our difficulties and our life be transformed by the very love of God himself, who gave us himself and his Son as a mere piece of bread, as crushed grapes. This is the Lord. As St. Augustine reminds us, what we are, what we eat. What we eat becomes who we are. You and I were called to bring Christ out from this church into that world, to bring peace and stability amidst the insanity of our society today, in the midst of the frustration and the riots, the uneasiness, and the violence. We're called not to add to that fuel, to quench it by our love, by our prayers, our sacrifices, our example. Christ experienced much evil in his life, and he conquered them all. So must we. And so we stand now to profess our beautiful faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son, is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. Mindful that Christ is the true bread of heaven, we present our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
For the Church, that in this time of fear and uncertainty, it extends compassionate arms towards the world, offering words of consolation and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who serve in our military, our police, and fire departments, may they be kept from all harm and return home safely, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our benefactors, may they be blessed for their generosity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the faithful departed from our parish who have gone before us in faith and love, may they receive the reward of their goodness. And let us remember in a special way at this Mass, Patrick Dolphin. May they receive the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, we present to God our particular intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, you offer your only Son in the sacrament of the Eucharist. We humbly bring our prayers in the name of Christ, who is Lord, forever and ever. Amen. Church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery, and the offerings we here present through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper, with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come
the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by the sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. So, we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of the angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The history of faith.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with our beloved patroness, Saint Margaret, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Jesus Christ. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, but not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace. Lord, be with you always.
And drinks my blood, abides in me, and I am him, says the Lord.
Those of you who cannot receive communion now, we offer now the act of spiritual communion. By Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I am unable at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Again, as a reminder, when you come up for communion, please be keep distance. While that clock will be over there, I'll be here in the
thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in this present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. This Friday is Reconciliation Friday. As you know, Reconciliation Monday we couldn't have in Lent. So this Friday from 10 until 12 noon, and again from 4 until 6, Father Clarke and I will be hearing confessions, as well as every Catholic church in the Archdiocese of New York. So it's good for us to go to confession, huh? Lack of patience, anger, attempted murder sometimes, whatever it happens to be. So it's a chance for us to kind of refresh ourselves. So this Friday here at church. As you leave church today, you can use all the exits. We ask you please, again, be careful and just don't bunch up. And if you try, I know it's hard, but try not to socialize in the front plaza. That would be great as well. God bless you. It's so wonderful. I'm sorry I won't be able to greet you after Mass, but it's so wonderful to see all of you back home. And until that wonderful day, when all of us are coming back in really the real way of the way we're so used to, we pray for one another and pray for those who are at home as well. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth. The Mass is ended.